Millions of Cats by Wanda Gág. This book was published originally in 1928 and it's been republished several times since. And it turns out quite a few of the people here are familiar with it and love it as well. I love it because it's got lots of cats in it for a start, but also I love the woodcut drawings, the woodcut illustrations. And I love the idea of what happens when you don't make decisions about enough. And they end up with a horde of cats potentially. I love the way the repetition occurs in the language as well. I was trying to find an example of it. This is a good little paragraph here. He's begun to find kittens and cats, and then now over there he saw a cat which had brown and yellow stripes like a baby tiger. "I simply must take it," cried the very old man, and he did. And you can see he's already got lots of cats arranged around his person. And then we've got to where it starts to see the repetition in particular, which it says, "It was very funny to see those hundreds and thousands and millions and billions and trillions of cats following him," which becomes a theme on the pages. "They come to a pond, mew, mew, we are thirsty," cried the hundreds of cats, thousands of cats, millions and billions of trillions of cats. "So, well, here is a great deal of water," said the very old man. "Each cat took a sip of water and the pond was gone." So it's brilliant. And then, you know, he goes home and it's like the Pied Piper of Hamelin, except it's cats, and he's carried them all with him. "Cats here, cats there, cats and kittens everywhere, hundreds of cats, thousands of cats, millions and billions and trillions of cats. And then we get the story of how they all disappear because they've eaten each other, which is a slightly unusual way of resolving the problem. Then they could not see a single cat. I think they must have eaten each other all up, said the very old woman. "It's too bad. But look," said the very old man, and he pointed to a bunch of high grass. In it sat one little frightened kitten. They went out and picked it up. It was thin and scraggly. Every day they gave it plenty of milk, and soon it grew nice and plump. "And it is a very pretty cat after all," said the very old woman. "It is the most beautiful cat in the whole world," said the very old man. "I ought to know, for I've seen hundreds of cats, thousands of cats, millions and billions and trillions of cats, and not one was as pretty as this one." Mm-hmm.